Doom is one of the true classics of gaming. It deserves a spot right beside Pac-Man and Mario with its legendary status. This is the most important first-person shooter that would truly define the genre, along with Castle Wolfenstein in the early 90s. It's not the first first-person shooter, but it's the first one to have a true mass-market influence. Doom is all about action and ambiance. You just have to kill everything that moves, but you also feel like you're right there, in the action, blasting at hordes of demons you just try to survive to get the hell out of hell. And by the way, that's where you are much of the game. Hell, this is a hardcore head-banging, gore-filled demonic action fest that just screams early 90s. Doom was the brainchild of John Romero and John Carmack, along with Tom Hall, Santi Peterson, Dave Taylor, and Adrian Carmack. Doom is split up into four episodes. When it came out, Doom was shareware, so the first chapter was free, and you had to cough up some cash for chapters 2 and 3. Chapter 4 was added a few years later. There isn't much story here, but what is here is pretty cool. You play as Doom Guy, the ultra-hardcore space marine with a heart of gold. You are on a punishment assignment after refusing to kill innocent civilians. The military is up to its usual stuff. You know, creating gateways between the moons of Mars, Phoebus, and Deimos. One day, Deimos just disappears, being replaced by hell itself. Your group goes off to investigate while you are left to stand guard outside. Everybody else is brutally doomed. It's now up to you and your wits. You gotta beat all these demons that have taken over this moon base. The first chapter, Knee Deep of the Dead, you will be shooting your way through military bases, computer tech centers, power plants, and the available moon Phoebes. The end of the first chapter has you transporting to the Hell Moon Deimos. In the second chapter, the shores of Hell, you fight various installations on Deimos. At the chapter's end, you discover the moon is literally sitting on top of Hell. The third chapter, Inferno, begins after you get off the surface of Deimos and go right to Hell. You must now make your way through Hell itself and escape. You have made it off the moon, but it's not over yet. There was a fourth chapter released called Thy Flesh Consumed. The demons have invaded Earth. You must travel back to Earth and fight for the sovereignty of your home. There is no success here, my friends, but the story continues in Doom 2. The story is all told very quickly between chapters. The story that's here is very good, and it doesn't get in the way of the action, which is what Doom is really all about in the end. The gameplay is where this gem really shines. Everything just feels so right in Doom. The controls are perfect. You really feel like Doom Guy is an extension of your thoughts, so you can control him so effortlessly. They spent a lot of time nailing the controls. The game is also excellently paced. The non-stop action isn't really non-stop. You need those dips in the action every now and then, collect your wits and ammo, and then get right back into glorious battle. This is a first-person shooter, and when you get right down to it, the protagonist is just a set of arms and some good weapons. The weapons in Doom are great. You have your melee fists of fury, and this is not the desired way of combat unless you are in berserk mode or whatever it's called, and even then I usually opt for a weapon. You have your basic pistol. Use this only if you need to, it's the weakest weapon. The shotgun is my favorite overall, as it's powerful against most foes, and it can kill multiple enemies at once. Plus, the shotgun is just so satisfying to use. You have your chainsaw. This weapon makes the game harder for you unless you're killing the grunts, but it's just so satisfying to use. and you don't need to collect fuel for it, so that's a plus. The chain gun is awesome with crowd dispersion and large enemies. The rocket launcher is powerful, but just be careful to not accidentally KO yourself. The plasma gun shoots balls of plasma. This is superior to the chain gun at crowd control. Then there's the BFG, the big fucking gun. It's got a bit of power-up time and can be tough to aim, but it shoots a super powerful shot. That's fantastic for boss encounters. Shooting may take some getting used to, but it's actually much simpler than any modern take, so it shouldn't take too long. You can only aim your gun left or right, and not up and down. No matter where the enemy is, as long as you are within the line of sight of the horizontal plane, then you can hit said enemy. It's really very simple, but different, if you are used to having, you know, proper aiming. Doom follows a pretty simple mission formula. You have an area or level. The level is populated with a set number of enemies. Each level has three key types: red, blue, and yellow. You need to collect the keys to open the doors, which will eventually lead you to the finish. In some levels, you don't even need to collect all the keys, but if you like looking for secrets, you're going to want to get all the keys and press the action button against every wall looking for hidden areas. The levels are all very well designed. Every wall, every explosive barrow, and every piece of ammo placement is well thought out and implemented. This is an expertly crafted masterpiece of level design that inspired every other first-person shooter that came after it. Okay, now on to the graphics. This is up to you, really. If you are able to enjoy an older game and appreciate it for what it was in its time, then these are excellent graphics. The sprites are well detailed and they have a good amount of personality infused into its pixel DNA. The sprites also look fantastic for a game developed in 1993. It's really mostly a mess of blurry low-res textures, but this was really good in 1993. There just weren't many games like this at the time, and Doom really set the standard in every area. The music is top-notch. They got Bobby Prince to do the music. The music of Doom is a mix of techno and heavy metal. There's also a lot of ambient music tracks in the game. And this was Prince's idea, as he believed some quiet areas would increase the tension. The music is a mix of Romero's techno metal vision and Prince's quieter, more ambient version. And it just works so well here. Doom is a very important game to the first-person shooter genre, and it's really a masterpiece title that still holds up today. The gameplay is rock solid with great controls and excellent pacing. The graphics are great for its time, and the music just fits the game so well. Doom is a masterpiece title that needs to be played by anyone hoping to get their hardcore gaming card. This game gets a 10 out of 10.